Today we are going to discuss an introductory part of the DT and the NDT. Basically, we are in the class of the NDT. So, but before moving toward the NDT, we need to understand why it is so called NDT and what are the requirement of this. Why it is came into the features and in the light when we have another kind of a test is available. So the DT is nothing, the NDT is nothing, just a non-destructive testing. And in the similar, there is a test that is for the destructive testing. So these DT and NDT are both are the both are the very important kind of testing techniques that is utilizing for performing the operations. So destructive testing basically utilizing to identify the physical property of the material, whereas the NDT is for the internal flaws and the defects. So moving toward why we are going to discuss the destructive and the non-destructive and why it is utilized. So हम बात कर रहे हैं डीटी और एनडीटी टेस्ट की. जो डीटी टेस्ट है वो बेसिकली डिस्ट्रक्टिव टेस्ट के नाम से जाना जाता है और एनडीटी टेस्ट है वो नॉन डिस्ट्रक्टिव टेस्ट के नाम से जाना जाता है. तो डिस्ट्रक्टिव टेस्ट बेसिकली मैकेनिकल प्रॉपर्टी की, जो फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टी मैकेनिकल प्रॉपर्टी होती है मेटल की, उनको जानने के लिए हम लोग यूटिलाइज करते हैं. एंड जो एनडीटी है वो मटेरियल की फिटनेस बेसिकली या फिर उसके इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर में कोई डिफेक्ट या फ्लॉज नहीं है उनको डिटेक्ट करने के रिस्पेक्ट में हम लोग आइडेंटिफाई करते हैं. सो दीज बोथ आर द वेरी मोस्ट कॉमन टेक्निक दैट वी आर यूटिलाइजिंग. तो डीटी टेस्ट को हम लोग बेसिकली मटेरियल के परफॉर्मेंस जो स्ट्रेंथ है उसको चेक करने के लिए परफॉर्म करते हैं. और इस डीटी टेस्ट का नाम इसीलिए डिस्ट्रक्टिव टेस्टिंग पड़ा क्योंकि जो मटेरियल है उस मटेरियल को हम लोग ब्रेक करते हैं उसके मैक्सिमम स्ट्रेंथ तक और उसको हम एग्जामिन करते हैं कि भाई ये मटेरियल जो है उसकी जो मैकेनिकल स्ट्रेंथ है कितनी है, उसको चेक करने के लिए हम लोग डिस्ट्रक्टिव टेस्ट को परफॉर्म करते हैं. इन शॉर्ट डिस्ट्रक्टिव टेस्ट में हम मटेरियल को तोड़ के उसके मैक्सिमम मैकेनिकल स्ट्रेंथ को एग्जामिन करते हैं. बट इन एनडीटी के केस में ऐसा नहीं है. एनडीटी में हम बिना तोड़े ही मटेरियल को इंस्पेक्ट करते हैं. मींस हम मटेरियल को उसके इंटरनल जो क्रैक्स या फ्लॉज हैं उनको आइडेंटिफाई करने के लिए हम लोग बेसिकली उसको यूटिलाइज करते हैं. राइट. सो मूविंग टूवर्ड विद द डेफिनेशन, द डिस्ट्रक्टिव टेस्टिंग इज अ फॉर्म ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट एनालिसिस दैट इन्वॉल्व अप्लाइंग द टेस्ट अ ब्रेक डाउन अ पर्टिकुलर मटेरियल to determine its physical property such as mechanical property of the strength, toughness, flexibility, hardness such as various another kind of properties that we need to examine in the destructive testing on the material as well. And these automobile crash tests are well known for the destructive test as well. So as you can see, there is a crash test of the aircraft which is taking place, and beside that there is a tensile test specimen is also located to check the tensile strength of the material. So these tests basically carry out to identify the strength of the material and the prolonged endurance testing that operating condition. So the it continue until the component equipment or the product displacement fail and is to be destroyed. So the purpose of destructive and non-destructive testing is to determine service life and to detect design weakness that may not show up under the normal condition. बहुत बार ऐसा होता है कि हमें लगता है कि वैसे तो जितने भी स्टैंडर्ड प्रोडक्ट्स होते हैं उन प्रोडक्ट्स को तो हम लोग विद द हेल्प ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड जो स्टैंडर्ड है उसके थ्रू ही बनाते हैं. बट व्हाट हैपनिंग इज उसमें भी कभी कभी ह्यूमन एरर्स या फिर मशीनिंग एरर या किसी भी तरह की प्रॉब्लम्स की आ जाती है, जिसके वजह से जो टेस्ट स्पेसिमेन है, जो भी वर्क पीस है या कंपोनेंट है, उसमें कोई किसी प्रकार की प्रॉब्लम आने की वजह से जो कंपोनेंट होता है उसका स्ट्रेंथ जो होता है वो कम पड़ जाता है. सो उस तरह के फेलियर को अवॉइड करने के लिए हमें डिस्ट्रक्टिव टेस्ट को बेसिकली परफॉर्म करना पड़ता है. राइट. सो नाउ द डिस्ट्रक्टिव टेस्टिंग ऑफ द मटेरियल, सो उसी के रिस्पेक्ट में है ये सारी चीज़ें. नाउ द इन द डिस्ट्रक्टिव टेस्टिंग फॉर द डिस्ट्रक्टिव फिजिकल एनालिसिस एनालिसिस दैट इज DPA टेस्ट दैट आर कैरीड आउट इन द स्पेसिमेन फेलियर इन ऑर्डर टू अंडरस्टैंड अ स्पेसिमेन परफॉर्मेंस और द मटेरियल बिहेवियर अंडर डिफरेंट डिफरेंट लोड. अगर किसी मटेरियल के ऊपर तरह तरह के लोड लग रहे हैं, तरह तरह के लोड लगने का मतलब ये है कि भाई जब वो कंपोनेंट अपने सर्विस में आएगा तो उसके वर्किंग कंडीशंस क्या होगी, क्या सिचुएशंस होंगे जिसके भी हाफ पे हम ये आइडेंटिफाई कर सकते हैं कि भाई ये मटेरियल जो है इस कंडीशन में सस्टेन कर जाएगा. तो अब जो जिस कंडीशन में हम मटेरियल को या कंपोनेंट को बना रहे हैं उस कंडीशन में और जिसमें वो बेसिकली यूटिलाइज हो रहा है उस कंडीशन में बहुत अंतर होता है. तो जो भी अगर कोई कंपोनेंट है वो बन रहा है और अपने सर्विस में जब जाके काम कर रहा है तो वहाँ पे उसकी स्ट्रेंथ की रियल एग्जामिनेशन होती है. तो उस तरह के कंडीशंस को झेलने के लिए हम कंपोनेंट को क्रिएट करते हैं, राइट. और उस तरह के कंडीशन को झेलने के लिए ही इस तरह के कंपोनेंट को टेस्ट किया जाता है कि जब वो अपने सर्विस में रहे तो अगर किसी प्रकार की अनइवन लोडिंग हो रही हो मटेरियल के ऊपर तो वो उसको झेल सके, सस्टेन कर सके और जो सर्विसिबिलिटी है किसी भी कंपोनेंट को उसको बना के रखे. मूविंग टूवर्ड द नेक्स्ट, दीज टेस्ट आर जनरली मच ईजियर टू कैरीड आउट, यील्ड मोर इंफॉर्मेशन एंड आर ईजियर टू इंटरप्रेट दैन नॉन डिस्ट्रक्टिव टेस्टिंग. ऑब्वियसली दीज आर द वेल एंड ईजियर मैथड दैट वॉट वी नीड टू डू इज़ दैट सिंपली जस्ट पुट द टेस्ट स्पेसिमेन इन टू द मटेरियल एंड अप्लाइंग द वेरियस प्रेशर अप टू इट्स फेलियर. सो इट इज़ जस्ट दैट काइंड ऑफ अ वर्क टू बी परफॉर्म जस्ट टू पुट द मटेरियल ऑन द मशीन एंड प्रोवाइड द काइंड ऑफ अ load and to break down the material and find out the result that how much the load that material is to be bear. So this is the simple as compared to the NDT. And then the moving toward the destructive testing is more suitable and economical for the object which will be mass produced, and the cost for the destroying a small number of specimen is negligible. So mass level पे अगर हम किसी component को बना रहे हैं उसके respect में ये जो DT test है वो कहीं ज़्यादा हद तक successful है. It is usually not economical to destructive testing where only one universal testing machine or very few item are to be produced. So this point is to be considered as well that when only one testing machine is available and we need to perform, so these kind of things we need to avoid, right. So detecting the failure can accomplish using a sound detector or the stress gauge and which is produce a signal to trigger the high speed camera as well. And then the if we are अभी तक तो हम लोग बात कर रहे थे कि भाई किसी मटेरियल को टेस्ट करें और उसको उसके एग्जामिन करें. जैसे कि आपको ये प्लेन के क्रैश टेस्ट के बारे में बताया गया, तो ये प्लेन का क्रैश टेस्ट इसलिए किया गया भाई जो उसको मटेरियल को हम लोग बना रहे हैं प्लेन के क्रैश प्लेन से प्लेन को जिस मटेरियल से बना रहे हैं क्या वो मटेरियल इतने इस तरह के सडन इम्पैक्ट को झेलने के लिए लायक है कि नहीं. ये उस प्रोसेस को करने उस कंपोनेंट को एक बेहतर कंपोनेंट बनाने के रिस्पेक्ट में है कि नहीं है, तो इस सब चीज़ों को हम लोग चेक करने के लिए बनाते हैं. तो ये तो हो गया क्रैश टेस्ट की बात, राइट. तो अब अगर हम किसी बड़े स्ट्रक्चरल टेस्ट की बात करें तो बड़े सिस्टम में भी हम देख रहे हैं बिल्डिंग स्ट्रक्चर है या लार्ज बिल्डिंग स्ट्रक्चर है, ठीक है, जैसे डैम हो गया, ब्रिज हो गया, तो they are rarely subjected to destructive testing due to the probability of the cost of the constructing and building or a scale modeling of a building just to destroy it. So ek 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 inka namune type mein hum log structure ko usi material se banate hain jisse wo dam aur baki bade components banne hote hain, and then we need to check that up to their failure. And the destructive test that are most frequently carried out for the structure which are to be constructed in earthquake zone, obviously, and such tests are sometimes referred to as crash test. and they are carried out to verify the design, seismic performance of a new building, or the actual performance of an existing building. So these tests are mostly carried out on a platform called a shake table, where we are providing a kind of a vibration seismic level, and that shake table, which is designed to shake in the same manner as an earthquake. And result of those tests often include the corresponding shake table videos, and then we form. And the testing of the structure in earthquake is increasingly done by modeling the structure using specialist finite element software. So these are the advanced technique that is utilizing to analyze the where the vibration is most effective on the dams model or on the building. So these are the very much important thing that we need to consider when we are going for the large kind of a structure to be inspected. So these are the basic introductionary part of the DT, and now we are moving towards this kind of a types of DT and NDT. So this destructive testing is nothing just kind of a crash test, hardness test, tensile test, impact test, creep test, fatigue test, torsion test, bend test, crush testing, double and single shear test, flattening test. And then the non-destructive testing is a kind of a visual testing, leak testing, the magnetic particle inspection, the dye penetration testing, ultrasonic testing, the radiography testing, electromagnetic testing. They are then we have eddy current testing and thermography, infrared testing, laser testing, positive material identification, PMI. So these all are the kind of NDT test which developed for identifying a various kind of test, various kind for the various kind of materials. So these are the most important thing that we need to discuss. So that is the just an introductionary part that we discussed in the class. Now there is a difference between the DT and the NDT that is shown in this list. So I'm just so we are moving with the differentiate that the destructive test that usually simulate one of more service condition, consequently they tend to measure serviceability and directly reliability as well. Now for the non-destructive test, the test usually involve indirect measurement of the property of no direct signification service. The correlation between this measurement and serviceability must be proven by other means. And the second one, the tests are in the destructive testing. Yes, obviously. So these tests are usually quantitative, measurement of load for failure, significant distortion or damage of life to failure under given loading and environmental condition. Consequently, they are yield numerical data useful for design purpose or for stabilizing standard or specifications. So these tests are in the similar, if we are talking about the NDT, these tests are usually quantitative and rarely quantitative. They do not usually measure load for failure or life to failure. Even indirectly, they may however reveal the damage of exposed, the mechanism of failure, and so on. So now the moving toward the destructive test are usually convenient to apply to parts in service. Generally, service must be interrupted and the part permanently removed from service. And in the other hand, if you are talking about the non-destructive test, it may be often be applied to part in service, assemblies without interruptions or service beyond normal maintenance or idle period. They involve no less of serviceable parts. Now destructive testing, again the cumulative changes over period of time cannot readily repeat, and if several units from the same lot of services are tested in succession over a period of time, it must be proven that the units were initially similar if the units are used in the service. So these are the various aspects that utilizing and differentiating between the DT and the NDT. Now the non-destructive test permits a repeated check of a given unit over a period of time. In this way, the rate of service damage, if detectable, and its correlation with the service failure may be stabilized clearly. Now, so these are the just introductory part that we are discussing. And furthermore, we will discuss in the next class. Till then, we are just checking out this. And we have lots of points to be discussed in this particular descriptive test. The part of very high material or fabrication cost, the cost or replacing the part destroyed may be prohibited. So these are the major issues that the DT test is to be faced. And in NDT, the acceptable part of very high material or fabrication cost are not lost in the non-destructive testing, because we can perform repeatedly test on the material without damaging it. But in the DT, the main cause is to destroy the material, the how much material we will destroy. So that consideration need to be taken care when we perform the destructive and the non-destructive test. So tests are not made on the object actually used in service. Consequently, the correlation or similarity between the object tested and those used in the service must be proven by other means. And the tests are made directly upon the object to be used in service consequently, and there is no doubt that the tests were made on repetitive test object. So these kind of points that we are making and to learn about the destructive and the non-destructive tests. So I'm going to explain these points again. The test can be made on only a fraction of production loss to be used in the service. They may have a little value when the properties vary unpredictably from unit to unit. Test can be made on every unit to be used in service if economically justified. Consequently, they may be used even when great differences from unit to unit occur in production lots. And then further, the last not the least, the test often cannot be made on the complete production of parts, and the tests are often limited to the test part or from the production part or from special materials and specimen process to simulate. So the property of the part to be used in service. And where the NDT, the test may be made on the entire production part or in all critical region of it. Consequently, the evaluation applies to part as a whole. Many critical section of the part may be examined simultaneously or sequentially as convenient and expedient. A single destructive test may measure only on or a few of the property that may be critical under service condition, and many non-destructive tests each sensitive to different properties of region of the material or part may be applied simultaneously or in a sequence. This way, it is feasible to measure as many different properties to properties that correlated with the service performance as desire. So these are the differences that we need to identify and differentiate between the DT and the NDT to check out that how these things to be happen. And that is how we can differentiate this big DT and NDT method to examine the specimens. So these are the very important things, the differences that we need to discuss. And furthermore, we will continue with this slides. And till if then any query or any doubt, so we can talk to it. Okay, so till now I am holding this lecture, and
नहीं, इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी विल मीट टू फाइंड आउट. टिल देन
थैंक यू.